special features that nearly went the way of the dodo, as Bill Jones now reports.
They're the last of the breed, elegant, aristocratic, exciting. They're called Thames A-raters, and whilst it's accurate to describe them as dinghies, well, it's like calling caviar fish eggs. They date from the 1860s and are called A-raters because they're built to a formula which the Victorians devised to codify and handicap sailing boats so they could race together. Rather like thoroughbreds are handicapped in horse racing. And Thames raters are thoroughbreds. Broad of beam, shallow draft, no fixed keel, disproportionately tall mast to maximise sail area. They're fast, extremely manoeuvrable, and like all thoroughbreds, capricious. These supercharged dinghies are not for the novice.
They carry a lot of sail area, which was originally put up there to reach the light winds that come over the top of the trees on the riverbanks here. And if you do get anything like a decent breeze, they can become a real handful.
A century ago, raters were usually match raced, one on one, sometimes for a wage of £1,000. In today's terms, that's £50,000 riding on a single race. Their owners were well-heeled and snobbish. They wouldn't get their hands dirty.
Oh, no, fair. I won't say that they sailed in white gloves. Some of them ought to have done, but they liked to take life easy in those days. They'd come down dressed in their number ones, sit in the bar with their caps off, and having their... It was generally Scotch in those days. And they left us to rig the boats. And then they'd come out and look, yes, put in one reef, and then go back and have another thing. And they'd wait until the 5-minute gun went, and they'd come down, and they'd step on board, and off they'd go. They'd sail their race very hard, and we'd come back here into the bar and left us to put the boats to bed.
Nowadays, raters are usually owned by syndicates. The costs are so high. One of these